This is the ABC Television Network. Welcome to American Top 40. I'm Casey Overdub, and this is our countdown of the 40 best-selling outtakes in the nation. We've got 4 new outtakes on the survey this week, along with the latest outtakes by Charlie Parker, Dick McDonough, John Larrabee, and Paul Payton. We're about to review the biggest outtakes in the nation by the biggest bunch of bimbos in the world. So let's get the countdown rolling on right here. Last year, this DJ had his first outtake. It got all the way up to number 45. This week, he debuts at number 40, and here is his latest screw-up.
Stay tuned in, and be sure you're in the Big D fan stand. Get yourself off.
Oh.
Ah, nice healthy shit. You gotta play that for Crow. He'd eat that shit up.
That was Mike Taylor on AT-40 with another winner, and Mike truly is a winner.
Are you recording this for fucking blooper tapes?
Here's a clown who's at number 39 this week, and he's on his way out.
You're telling me you have a level problem. You're also getting some tapes ready for the Christmas party, aren't you?
You look so guilty.
Whoa, whoa, listen to the music.
Let me hear that back.
That's Jim English at AT-40, falling from number 23 to number 39 with his outtake. Coming up, a special award was given to one of our outtake stars this year. It was a broadcast award, and has never been given to a person before. Details coming up.
Say, when was the last time you had a good blowjob? Don't you need a good blowjob again? Well, Irving's Blowjobs, located at across the street from and down two lights and turn left, has the best blowjob in town. Irving's gives you feature A and feature B and feature C. And while we're at it, if you mention this ad, get a 10% discount with feature D. So remember, the next time you need a blowjob, that's Irving's Blowjob, located at across the street from and down the hall. Tell them you heard about it at WDRC.
From Hollywood, this is Casey Overdub, and the countdown doesn't stop until we reach number one. At number 38, another debut.
Early American traditional and contemporary gifts
most appreciated Christmas morning come from Plainville Wayside Furniture. Select from rockers, recliners, desks, love chests, plus Plainville Wayside's entire stock of lamps, pictures, and mirrors. All reduced at least 20% from Plainville's Wayside. Shop today till 5:30 and Sunday from 1 to 5 p.m. during the last 2 days of Plainville Wayside Furniture's floor sample clear-out sale. You'll save 20 to 68% on quality Early American traditional and contemporary gifts most appreciated Christmas morning come from Plainville Wayside Furniture. Select from rockers, recliners, desks, love chests.
Love that? Yeah, I'd appreciate that on Christmas morning. Give me a little love with your chest, man. Go make love to your body.
Debuting at number 38, good old JML himself, John Larrabee. And now here's that AT-40 Extra. You know, a few months ago, a DJ won a pretty big award, which was never been given to a person before, or even a human being. The International Radio Program Forum, sponsored by the town of Enfield, presents an award to broadcast excellence for outstanding service in public affairs programming. And for 9 years now, the award has been given to only radio stations, never to an individual. Well, that changed in 1976 presentations last December. The winner was a pop outtake bimbo. You see, one man began an annual Thanksgiving radiothon in Hartford, Connecticut in 1975 to help reduce hunger in the area. Twice now, in the past 2 years, this DJ has held a radiothon consisting of himself, information all about himself. And he's successfully taken the program nowhere. And he's raised one can of tuna fish. Yes, he's one of JC's outstanding Old Men of America for 1977. And here he is with his latest outtake as a disc jerk.
I'm Brad Davis. You've heard me talk about Computer Processing Institute over there at East Hartford and what great instructors they have. Well, I'd like to read a letter addressed to Bob Laughlin, CPI's placement director from a major insurance company here in Connecticut. The letter reads, Dear Bob, fuck you. We've been dealing with CPI for several years now and have had very, very good luck with their graduates. The majority of these are bright, eager, and motivated and fit into our environment with a minimum of effort. Continue. Does this bot? Oh, shit. I'm Brad Davis with exciting news about the savings you'll find on Dunlop snow tires through Sunday at National Family Discount Center, Snafford Springs. National has good quality Dunlop for... Oh, shit. Fuck it. Jesus Christ, you know, I'm not going to stay here all fucking day with this. I'm Brad Davis, and I'm a disc jockey. So, oh, fuck. Who wrote that fucking thing in there?
And that's Mr. Hartford. Winner of Billboard's Award for Programming Excellence by the Town of Enfield in 1976. Congratulations, Brad. You're a real good disc jockey.
I am not a disc jockey.
And now, here's number 37.
Save up to 30% on diamonds, watches, rings, pendants, and earrings during the Diamond Showcase's anniversary sale by giving her...
Damn it! 36 OTs to number one and count them down.
WDRC, FM and AM stereo, Hartford.
3 minutes with AT-40, and you know what your favorite outtakes are on the National Outtake scene. Now, on with the countdown.
Number 35.
For Veterans Day, join Enfield Square's Sale-a-thon when we salute the holiday with super savings and extended shaving hours. For Veterans Day, join Enfield Square's Sale-a-thon when we salute the holiday with... My tie is doing it. For Veterans Day, join Enfield Square's Sale-a-thon when we salute the holiday with super savings and extended shopping hours. On Friday, November 11th, Enfield Square Shopping Center will open for business from 9 a.m. until 9:30 p.m. So for big values and personalized service, join us on Veterans Day with goddamn coffee.
Now on with the countdown!
Now here's the only group to appear on AT-40 this week. They have a good track record for writing many outtakes, most of which went to number one. Now they have gone on to the recording field themselves and recording many outtakes, but not performing together, but separately. At number 31 and up from 33, here are the account execs.
Just mention the retail. Don't forget for your holiday seafood preparations, the retail section upstairs with all kinds of fresh seafood and shellfish and lobsters.
The whole fucking stuff.
That's all. Jesus,
that's one thing. That's all. One line.
That's all.
Here. Plus on another line.
They have codfish balls. Don't forget the retail. You know, how the fuck did I ever get in this business? Don't forget the retail.
While you're at Subway, the insulation people down there.
They blow your mind. You didn't lose a lot of money on that, did you?
What?
You didn't lose a lot of money on that, did you? You didn't lose a lot of money on that?
No, $100 a week, but don't worry about it.
What are you fucking laughing at?
Is it true, Brad, that when you were a youngster that your folks were so poor that if you hadn't been a boy, you would have nothing to play with for Christmas?
I'm going to leave that out because it doesn't... I can play with that live, you know?
That's, you know, Christ, I've been up since 2:30.
Oh, I don't fucking believe this.
I can't believe it. It's going to be the worst thing that ever happened.
Don't jerk me off, you know.
Number 30.
At number 30, here's a real winner and done by a real winner. Another real winner on our real winning AT-40 on the OTs of the week.
Where can you find Levi's, Wrangler, and Maverick jeans with values to $19.99 for just $9.88 and student cuts for $8.88? Where? At C Parks Department Store, 317 Main Street, East Hartford. Get to C Parks Department Store, 317 Main Street, East Hartford, just south of Pratt & Whitney. This Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday for the Super $9.99. Oh, shit, there it was again.
What the fuck do you want?
Run over with Ralph and the boys the wordings if you want to have one.
Come on, you know, fucking guys jerking me off here.
America!
You're listening to the top outtakes from Kid Con to Diamond Head.
Number 27.
Tomorrow, G-Fox is smashing prices. It's a Sunday smash. Tomorrow...
I know you can do that.
Tomorrow, G-Fox...
You did this.
Tomorrow, G-Fox is smashing prices.
It's a Sunday smash, tomorrow only at all G5 radio shows.
No, the old man goes into a whorehouse, right? And he's shaking like this, and he's going, I want to get laid. I want to get laid. And the madam says, you want to get laid? Yeah, I want to get laid. I want to get laid, please.
She says, my God, you look like you've already had it.
Well, really? How much do I owe you?
Now on with the countdown!
AT-40s heard from coast to coast and around the corner on terrible radio stations such as KUNT in Oxnard, California, WCOK in Wilmington, West Virginia, and WTIT in Lake Falls, Vermont.
Whether you're record shopping for gifts or just adding to your collection, when you want the best selection at the best prices, you want Al Franklin's Musical World in the Hartford Civic Center. Jethro Tull is coming to the Civic Center this Monday, and to celebrate, Al Franklin's will give you 40% off the complete Jethro Tull catalog from Chrysalis Records, including the new newest Jethro shit.
Here's an outtake that hasn't been heard in almost 2 years. It was last heard in 1975 in Hartford, Connecticut. So let's go back with an OBG outtake.
Dick Robinson here for Railroad Salvage Orange, Route 5 at East Windsor, also Orange and Groton, Connecticut, plus Trinity Falls, Massachusetts. Well, they say if we can't sell it to us, we just don't buy it. Well, as we promised in our last commercial, we'll tell you about the stereo buyout. Webcore stereo buyout. Nobody beats Railroad Salvage's deals on stereos. Now, for example, here's a solid-state Webcore stereo FM-AM radio, 8-track system with 4 speakers. It's a $200 value. Your price, $99.88 for the entire. And Ruby Vine just bought a $300,000 insurance buyout, current 1974 ladies' fashions. Now, would you believe they were hanging in a rack, ready to go to the shipping stores when the sprinklers let go. And you don't know what love is until your sprinklers let go.
What's that you say? You don't have the voice? Well, that's what makes Connecticut School of Broadcasting a good choice. At Connecticut School of Broadcasting, you'll have an opportunity to touch on all aspects of broadcasting, training and on-air disc jockey work, of course, but you'll become familiar with equipment operation, writing commercials, news, and sports, and the work that goes into broadcasting before the on-air light comes on. It's all designed to prepare you for your first job in broadcasting. You'll learn by doing with modern broadcast equipment. It's the best way to learn. Something more about that voice of yours. If it's average, you know, like most people, that's all you need. The Connecticut School of Broadcasting at Stratford, call them right now for some straight talk about your future. Nobody will fuck around with you. Besides, I'll never get this into 60 seconds.
Number 20.
At number 20, here's a man who has really, really come along on a survey. He's held the number one spot in the last 2 years for about 4 times. Now, debuting at number 20 with his great outtake of how to read a commercial and not burp at the same time.
I know I get top quality on Meat Street USA at the finest. For instance, USDA choice beef. Tender, juicy, naturally delicious steaks, roasts, and more. Yet priced to meet any competition. Just listen.
At number 19, here's an artist who has tried and tried and tried to record a commercial all in one take. Well, he finally did it. He got it in one take. But it took 100 before that. So we call him the 101 Take Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, West Farms this season, Bucks Vegan.
I practice this, David.
Minutes at AT-40, and we're counting them down, your favorite outtakes around the nation. At number 15, here's a young lady who's the only female on our AT-40 this week. Well, she debuted at number 40 and then went down to number 41 and is now all the way up to number 15. Because, well, if you look at her, you would see why. And here she is with her first and only commercial ever done on a radio station. And fortunately, for the station, it never got aired.
Well, look at my lip!
Sea Parks Department Store, 317 Main Street East, Hartford, announces the opening of their second store at 28 Garfield Street, Newington, in the old Marshall's building. And to celebrate, both Sea Park stores are offering Levi's, Wranglers, and Maverick jeans at fantastic prices. All jeans with values at $19.99 will be on sale for just $9.88. Student cuts, $8.88. Choose from many styles, cords, denims, jeans for just $9.88. Pre-washed jeans are just $11.88. You'll also find a complete line of jeans, jackets, and vests. And to go with those jeans, Sea Park has American-made flannel shirts for $3.
Hey, what's going on? Hey, touch me. And then,
hey,
do it over again. Watch what I'm making.
Sea Parks Department Store, 317 Main Street, East Hartford, announces the opening of their second store at 28 Garfield Street, Newington, in the old Marshalls building. And to celebrate, both Sea Park stores are offering Levi's, Wrangler, and Maverick jeans at fantastic prices. All jeans with values at 19... Fuck. Sea Parks Department Store at 1317... Where the fuck are you, 13? Take 99.
We have a letter from a listener who wants to know what bimbo held the number one position the longest. Well, details coming up. How you doing?
Good. You know what's over?
What's that?
Yep, it's over this month.
What's over?
Yep, it was great while it lasted, but it's all over at the end of June.
What are you talking about?
It's a shame, but you still have the month of June, but after that...
Would you please tell me what the heck you're talking about, please?
Righto, that's it. I took advantage of it.
Are you nuts? Would you mind telling me what you're talking about, you goddamn fool?
America!
We're counting right down to a new number one outtake of the week. My name is Casey Overdub, and this is American Top 40. And now to something more serious. We have a couple of guys here who want to tell us a story, tell us a very serious story. And now debuting for their first time on AT-40, they went from number 50 all the way up to
number 13.
One day, the red was, oh, she's walking through the woods and she ran into the big bad wolf. And the wolf said, "Where are you going, little red?" She said, "Well, I'm going to Granny's house, you big furry creep." And she went on, and the wolf went on. He took a shortcut. He got there, and he got rid of Granny, hopped in the bed, and waited for little red to show up. Well, little red showed up and came into the next to the bed and sat down and said, "Granny, what big eyes you have?" And the wolf said, "Well, the better to see you with, my dear." And she said, "But Granny, what big ears you have?" And the wolf said, the better to hear you with, my dear." And she said, "But Granny, what big teeth you have?" And the wolf said, "That's because I'm going to eat you up." Little Red thought and said, "Far out.
Lick my lip."
Oh, this guy goes into a bar and he sees a fellow that he believes he knows from years ago. And he looks at him and he says, "Eddie, is that you? Eddie." And this guy stares back and he says, "Al. God, I haven't seen you since high school days, right?" He said, "What have you been doing?" "So," Eddie says, "well, I'm married and got a family and I'm working and so on. What are you doing?" The guy says, "God, you'll never believe this." He says, "I'm working and everything, but I never not only didn't get married, but," he says, "I've never even been laid. And I'm 45 years old. I'm going nuts. I'd like to know what it's like to get laid." So this other guy says, "You've never been laid and you're 45. I can't believe it. How could that be possible?" The guy says, "I just didn't know how to, you know, I just couldn't make the approach and I just couldn't bring myself to do this. And, geez, I wish you, could you help me?" And the guy says, "I can help you in a minute, right off the bat. Tell you what, you meet me here in the same bar tomorrow." So Eddie leaves, and he goes out, and he goes down to this novelty store and buys one of these huge rubber girls. And he goes to a hotel, and he puts the rubber girl on the bed, rents the room, pays for the rent and everything, and then he goes back home. And then the next day he goes into the bar and he sees Al, holds out the key to the room, and he says, "Al, you're all set. It's all arranged. Go out there right now. You'll love it." The guy says, "I can't believe this." So the guy goes up to the hotel, goes up to the room, unlocks the door, and sees this rubber woman on his bed. So he lays down, he gets undressed, he lays down next to her. And a couple hours later, he comes back to the bar. And Eddie says, "Yeah, you're back. Well, what did I tell you? How did you like it? Wasn't it terrific?" Guy says, "God, I think I killed her." He says, "What do you mean you killed her?" He says, "I laid down on the bed,
bit a tit. She farted and flew out the window.
Fireside Furniture at 44 Catton is selling out to the bare walls and offering you the deal of a lifetime on famous brand name furniture of all kinds at prices below the manufacturer's cost. You'll find savings starting at 50% and more. Excuse me. Don't keep that either.
American Top 40.
And now we have that letter from Jake the Janitor in Windsor, Connecticut. Jake wants to know what bimbo held the number one position the longest. Well, the answer, in all of 1840's history, there's been only one bimbo to hold the number one position the longest. You see, back in 1932, Charlie Parker, now known as Big Roy, King of Funk, held the number one position with an outtake in which he said, "God damn, fuck me!" And from there, he went on to become one of the biggest custodians of broadcast history, and finally won the Broadcasting Honorary Director's Award. And now he works 8 days a week acting in a serial, portraying a raisin. Jake, thanks for your letter.
Now on with the countdown!
AT-40's heard coast to coast and around the world on such shitty stations as CRAP, Toronto, Canada, WFUK, Pittsmouth, Pennsylvania, and WDRC, Hartford, Connecticut.
Number five.
On the WDRC job line, an institutional cook is needed with an ability to cook special dietary foods. Persons applying for this $375 plus per hour, depending on experience position, should have some institutional cooking experience. Please call the Connecticut State Employment Service between 8:30 and 4:30 Monday through Friday at 56. I think the person has to be able to handle not banging their plates up right now.
Hi, I'm Brad Davis, your morning turkey.
That was not an outtake, but a true statement. How is that recorded? Details coming up.
Buddy Marino's Honda City open house days are now on at 71 Main Street, Middletown. Parts, accessories, riding gear, usually one-day service, and the exclusive 6-month, 6,000-mile warranty. You find big savings now at Buddy Marino's Honda City in Middletown. I told you, it's been fucking long.
Jumping up 11 points this week, from number 14 to number 3. The only guy who does his commercials on a skateboard.
Hey, that sounds a little like surfing, right? And it is. Only right now, it's even bigger than surfing all over the country. Skateboards are coming to Big Z, and you can win one free. Makaha skateboards with the shielded bearings. It's the original skateboard and the favorite of the pros. Wow, this is really easy.
I'm in the group now.
I can't hold it. You want my face to go into the fucking side of the building?
Yeah, don't you push me, you son of a bitch.
Makaha skateboards with the shielded bearings. You gotta walk. I'm holding because it keeps moving, you fucker.
You want me to break my fucking ball, that's why.
Now for the recording of a DJ that knew exactly what he was doing and saying. But how do you get a person to do that? Well, it's easy. First of all, the DJ has to be a bimbo. Now take that bimbo and put him in a recording studio and tell him anything. And this is how it's done.
Can you hear me? Close the door. I said...
All right, put your earphones in.
All right.
Well, what I want you to do is go, "Hi, I'm Brad Davis, gobble, gobble, gobble."
For a contest promotion we're doing. These guys have to do one, okay?
It's a concert promotion? The contest?
It's for a contest and we're going to be running on Thanksgiving.
"Hi, I'm Brad Davis." And what do I say?
Gobble, 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 okay. Like a turkey.
Okay.
All right. Give me a couple of them, we'll try it.
"Hi, I'm Brad Davis, gobble, gobble, gobble."
Try to sound more like a turkey, okay.
"Hi, I'm Brad Davis."
"Gobble, gobble, gobble."
Then you want a gobble, too? "Hi, I'm Brad Davis, your morning turkey."
"Gobble, gobble, gobble."
"Hi, I'm Brad Davis, your morning turkey." "Hi, I'm Brad Davis, your morning turkey." Gobble, gobble, gobble.
And now here's an artist with more outtakes on the AT-40 survey than any person dead or alive. In fact, he wrote this entire outtake by himself and recorded it by himself behind locked doors in the bathroom with pen in one hand and, well, you know what in the other hand. Here's Big Roy, King of Funk's outtake in which he performs himself
And now, with the number one outtake of the week, here is Big Roy, King of Funk. I don't know what time I'm going home, and it's time for me to go.
One.
Let me do this.
I may never get caught if this is all over. Come on. There's no reason to go home. You never even cry. There's no reason to go home. Cereal, cook it over the fire here.
Wish I had a fireplace.
For a stove. There's no reason to go home. You never even call anymore. No reason to wait for the phone. I don't want to go home and sit alone anymore, listening for your knock on the door. There was a time I used to wait for the end of each day to hear your voice. Standing there that way, might as well stay on the job. There's nothing else I really want to do, but I do know I'll be thinking of you.
Okay.
There you have it, a new number one song by the master of outtakes himself, Big Roy, King of Funk. This has been American Top 40, recorded in Hollywood via Hartford by Watermark Incorporated. Your executive producer was John Pretty and Bill Rotten. A Pretty Rotten production. Your producer engineer was Tom Ray, written and edited by Tom Ray and Dave What's-His-Name. Join us again next year when we count down 40 of the sickest outtakes in the country. And remember, keep your feet on the ground and keep reaching for those fucking stars.
Back home, folks.